Thank you, sir. Now, I would like to request Mr. Rajnikant Patel, sir, honorary director, GTU Graduate School of Smart Cities Development and advisor, research and consultancy cell of GTU, to say a few words about today's event.
Hello, dignitaries on dais and off the dais and friends. Today is a special day for a smart city initiative of GTU. As you know, there is a Graduate School of Smart Cities Development established here. And we are very fortunate that we have very distinguished keynote speaker from IBM, Mr. Kelkar, who is the head of India and South Asia for the smart city and urban development aspects. We have very interesting discussion and very fruitful things are expected now. I want to clarify certain things. There was one recent workshop 10 days back in a PDPU on a smart city where I was the chief guest. And there is a lot of confusion what is smart city. People still think smart city is something, you know, is an imagination. But I will just clarify what the smart city is. There are four categories of smart. First, as per definition of Government of India. First is area-based. That means area-based are three parts: retrofitting, redevelopment and greenfield. So these three are area development. Another is the planned city for whole city. Now I'll just give an example so it is clear to you. For example, Ahmedabad city, let's say. What is retrofitting? Badra area. You take the old area, just do some work, make it more beautiful and try to make it less smart. So it's not a whole smart city, the area is smart. Second example is the redevelopment. You take the area, you do the redevelopment of that area. What is the example? Ahmedabad? Sabarmati riverfront. That was taken up, old Dupatpatti were demolished and then we made that. So that portion is a smart city. Third is greenfield. In greenfield, example is a GIFT city. It's a new area, totally developed freshly. So that is a greenfield. So area-based, there are three definitions. Retrofitting, redevelopment and greenfield. Now, fourth is the planned city. Planned city is something you have a scheme which benefits to large population of the city. For example, BRTS in Ahmedabad. So that is a planned city solution. So that everybody can have a chance to use BRTS. So these are the four areas, how they are defined by Government of India and also accepted internationally. And if any proposal is to be made to Government of India or anywhere internationally, planned city component is compulsory. You have to have something, some scheme, because everybody should feel we are getting something. So one solution you have to provide is the planned city. In addition, area based, one or more you can provide. You can provide, you may not even provide. Planned city is a compulsory solution. So this is the definition, this is the way I think I wanted to clarify this confusion. And wherever I go, in front of many universities for this for smart city workshop, and most of these people, they do not know it's something new. It's not that they are not exposed. Once they are exposed, they understand. So when we say smart city, it is this type of thing. Smart city means, for example, it can be specialized. Like Dwarka can be smart city for tourism. Aurangabad can be smart city for tourism. Like, so like that. And then another example, educational smart city. For example, Gandhinagar can be smart city for education. There are 9 universities already. There can be more and more. Concept of smart city is to develop something, infrastructure, buildings, systems, totally integrated by ICT. There is a person. Any smart city, I give some example. Suppose I left my home and went to office. Then you say, oh, I forgot to turn off my air conditioner. Now I am in office. In a smart city, using my smartphone, I should be able to turn off my AC at my home. This is the ICT application. Two developments I want to tell you. We already have some desk work research going on, and we have faculty. Just raise your hand. They are our assistant professor who are involved in ICT and smart city work. They are going to make presentation also. Very interesting opponents. They are studying, but on a desk level, because there is no smart city lab. Now, I want to announce something very, very interesting for you, that on behalf of our Vice Chancellor, Dr. Akshay Agarwal, I am informing you that GTU, Graduate School of Smart City Development, has decided to set up integrated multi-group smart city lab in Gandhinagar campus. It's already decided. So, and we are having a dialogue with IBM. It will be with the cooperation and efforts of others. What this will do? See, if some company establishes smart city lab, it will require staff to do research, professor, right? Kahan se aayega? Kitne lenge? GTU has advantage because we have more than 100 engineering colleges and more than 100 MBA colleges. Both are required in smart city. So 200 colleges, imagine how much staff we have, or PhDs, professors and all. They are sitting there. But the smart city lab in Gandhinagar, through cloud, we will be giving them load so they can do research. Sitting in Surat, sitting in Rajkot, Balavidyanag or anywhere, who become our member, smart city member, you are even ultimately we may have other universities also who connect to us. We provide central facility. And our GTU staff, professors and all, they utilize to do research. What kind of research they have to decide. For example, Surat is coming up as a smart city very fast. I think Microsoft and IBM, they are involved in it. Now, suppose certain component, they have to do research, how it should be handled. Then, our engineering college in Surat, they can have a dialogue with them and do research based on our facility. So, this is very unique. I just talked to Mr. Kelka recently, this extraordinary example where you set up a central smart city lab. And all your 200 colleges can take the benefit for doing the research. So this is the scheme, this is the plan of smart city. As far as the research is concerned, on academic, we have offered e-course on a smart city development. From next month, it will be there. And then training, of course, is going on. We have a three-day training workshop, as you know. And it has so much in fact, all India, that one example I give you, after we had a few delegates from Haldia, West Bengal, they went back and I didn't know, but their person who was here, he was very close to Mamata Banerjee. So he talked to her and she said, let us have one day introductory workshop. So it was arranged just some time back. And first, what they did, they invited all IAS officers, IPS officers, technocrats, MLA, everybody, 200 people in the Haldia auditorium, and one day workshop, a smart introductory workshop. Starting, first thing they said, we are grateful to this Gujarat Technological University, where we got the training for 3 days, and this is the outcome of it, and it has induced us to move further. So that is the advantage of publicity we got. Same thing happened last week in Chandigarh, government of Haryana. They also held one day workshop and they are starting only they emphasize the training they got in GTU. So this is the plan, this is the action plan. I think you young research partners, how many are from Ahmedabad here? Please raise hand. Okay. Surat nahi aaye abhi. Okay. Rajkot? Okay. Anyway, maybe some they may be coming. 9:30 is a little bit early, but since we have to squeeze in, keep city busy, so we have to keep it little earlier. Okay, I think with this I will stop, and I am very appreciative that you all have come, and I hope that you will participate and take benefit of the year.